line asked was by a sixth grader. It was, if you hit it with a baseball bat, will it explode? The answer is, let's not find out. But, you know, if you guys have any questions, I'd love to, you know, field some of your questions. I know, exactly, right? The competitions, you know, they put together these set of rules that our students have to kind of whittle down and say, what are our design criteria? Because we have two different organizations, the World Solar Challenge in Australia and the American Solar Challenge in the U.S., and they have slightly different regulations. So right now, this term, our students have been taking both sets of regulations, going through and saying, all right, what are our design criteria that we have to fit into if we want to do both races? So one of them is the World Solar Challenge requires four wheels the next time around. The U.S. race still only requires three. So our students had to take that, you know, take those two parts and say, well, that kind of makes sense. We have to design a four-wheel car if we want to race in both races. And they've done that for the size of the car, for, you know, the stability of where the wheels are, the driver position. So we've really spent this first part of a two-year design cycle really focusing in on what are the design criteria that we need to be designing to. At the same time, we also have some students who are, you know, looking at, all right, what have we used before that we can carry forward? Like, are we going to use the same motor? Are we going to use the same motor controller, the same battery technology? So they're trying to identify what are the things that worked for us in the past that we can carry forward. So, you know, we do know that, you know, the exterior, the shape of the car is going to change, but there's some guts and things that are really at the heart of the car that can stay the same. So we've really been working on that.
Steering.
In the past, coming to this car, this last time around they said you had to have a steering wheel. Well, steering wheel. Before, there in 2001, the first time we used, it was UGS at the time, Unigraphics, we designed our car with a tiller. It was literally one-to-one steering. It was really, really simple. You know, I don't know why more cars don't have a tiller. Well, yeah, probably. But it was really simple. And then following that, we really wanted to shrink the package and make the car really thin. So we wanted to get rid of that tiller. And we went to tank steering or push-pull with wires. And we actually got F15 grips made with all the buttons that we wanted. And we hooked them on, and the driver would just do this in order to steer. Well, that was a really thin package, but then when we came around to design this car, they said, no, everybody has to have a steering wheel. So our students said, wouldn't it be really cool to have an F1 steering wheel? So what did, you know, this is great students, right? You know, and they look out and they try and find out how much does it cost to make an F1 steering wheel or get an F1 steering wheel. It's pretty much our entire budget. And I don't know what year that was in Florida that we went down to that conference. Do you remember, Steve? Was it 2009?
The Siemens?
Yeah, 2008 or something.
Hewless probably remembers.
We went
2009.
Hewless invited us to come down to the PLM World Conference in Orlando. And we had our previous car on display down there, and right next to us was a booth, and it was dimension printers, the 3D dimension printer. And I was really, really intrigued by, you know, being able to print things and prototype, and, you know, it would come in, you know, very, very valuable for my students. And so I made a major push to get one of those on campus. And using that 3D printer, our students built their own steering wheel, like an F1 steering wheel. This is actually printed ABS plus plastic from that prototyping machine. We went through several designs. The students would design it, print it, say, oh, I really would like to drive like this and not be able to crush my fingers. So before, this was straight, and we ducted in, and they said, oh, this button, I can reach that. It used to be up here. And so they were able to design something in NX, print it out, hold it in their hands, and say, all right, this is close, but we can do better. And then we took those prototypes at the time. We were only thinking of it as a prototyping machine. We took those prototypes and we said, I wonder if this would be strong enough to actually use in the car. So what did, you know, a bunch of excited students do, do you think? Close! They actually printed it out, they attached components, they put it in a vise, and started throwing their body around saying, all right, let's do some, you know, empirical testing of, will it break if I, you know, put all my weight trying to, you know, turn the steering wheel? The answer is, yes. But it only broke in certain places that the students had identified, this is probably going to be the weak point. And that weak point happened to be basically the connection, because the steering wheel is printed in layers. It happened to be this connection between the steering shaft and the steering wheel. So they said, all right, well, that doesn't mean we need to throw out the whole process because it broke where we thought it would break. Now we can be creative and say, how can we keep that spot from breaking? Well, if you haven't noticed already, the car is made out of almost complete carbon fiber. Carbon fiber, you can pretty much do anything with. So our students said, hey, let's add carbon fiber to the steering wheel to reinforce it. So they took just plain layups of carbon fiber, reinforced that joint, and went back to testing and said, hey, this works for us. So inside of, this is the steering wheel we actually used on the last race. It has a connector from a prosthetic limb, because it's the only connector that we got 29 pins out of. So as soon as you plug this in, all the buttons and the screen are all active. So just like an F1 wheel, when you put it on, you're good to go.